Yeah, good evening. Welcome to Motokraft here in on Urban, and your presenter is Richard Chiimba. As usual, in this program of Motokraft, we begin with a mechanical segment where we discover different aspects of cars. And one thing I need you to know, that everything on cars is worth knowledge, or is worth knowing, because when you know, you are not like somebody who doesn't know. And when you know, you have a certain level of confidence that is developed in you when it comes to vehicle concepts, as well as you'll be in position to advise people who come and ask you, all who are in dispute, so who are deliberating about different aspects of cars. And what we are looking at today, we are looking at the grille. The grille looks so simple, and to some people it's just a design, but behind that design there is a technical reason why the grille has been made in such a way that it is made. One, of course, the beauty of the car is not the primary reason why you have the grille on the car. The beauty is the secondary, you know, reason, but the first reason has to do with the technicality behind the grille and what it is used for. First and foremost, when most of the cars, when you look at them, you find that the grille has got provisions which are sort of holes that allow the intake of air. There is what we call drag resistance when you are driving a motor vehicle. For example, when you're driving, when you start the engine, you have the chemical energy turned into the heat energy and later mechanical energy, which allows the engine to operate. However, when the heat energy comes in, it must be regulated. And part of the regulation of the heat energy is the air that is entering into the vehicle, especially when you are driving. That's why when you look at a vehicle, any vehicle you see, for example, whether a station wagon or MPV or a saloon vehicle, you find that the front has what we call a grille, and the grille has some sort of segments and holes that go through, that when you are driving, you have a mass of air which is entering into the system through the grille. So that entering in of the air into the system through the grille is what in most cases will enhance what we call vehicle cooling system. So the enhancement of the vehicle cooling system, when you look at the grille, becomes more cardinal, because behind this grille lies the radiator unit, which radiates the heat that comes from the engine operation. So this is not just a simple design which is made on a motor vehicle. No, it is made in a technical and scientific manner to allow the inflow of air into the compartment of the engine, which is hot. However, there are vehicles that don't have the engine at the front. Like, for example, when you look at Hiaces, you find that the Hiace or any other vehicle, when you look at the front here, it has got very small vents that allow air to go in, just because you don't have the radiator straightened right there. It is situated right to a position where maybe the driver is seated, and you have fans that are erected under when it comes to the Hiace, as we will see in the program. So the grille plays a very fundamental and important role in making sure that it gathers up the air as you drive across the wind, and then directs it to the different sections in the vehicle that need cooling, especially the radiator unit. And once you have to seal this grille off, then you have problems with heating. I've seen people make mistakes. For example, you have a bus, or you have a vehicle which is carrying people, for example, maybe for a function, maybe for a burial, and you have somebody put a manila piece of paper, or put maybe a banner and cover the grille. That is not allowed in the technical sense, because you are restricting airflow into the engine. It's going to culminate definitely into the engine overheat, and once the engine overheats, then you're not like the after effects. So the manufacturers have left the grille in place to make sure that that the air which is coming into the engine has a passage where it passes. Now, depending from car to car, whichever car you look at, the small ones, the big ones, including the you know, the big buses, you have a section which has the grille, and that section must be respected. And in case you are one of the people who is making a mistake of covering the grill, please stop covering the grill, because the after effects are not really good. When it comes to European countries, it becomes a bit more different. Reason being that when the ambient temperatures are too low, the cooling, of course, is ineffective, in such a way that the engine is overcooled instead of being cooled normally. So what happens is we have what they call a radiator blind or a radiator shield, and in those circumstances, especially in winter, where the radiator shield is erected from within the vehicle, it has an electronic activation where you can put the radiator blind or the radiator shield, and then it shields the cold air from affecting the engine because the ambient temperatures are low. Well, you can do that in Europe and also in the US, where maybe the temperatures are low, but not here in the tropics, where we have temperatures which are, you know, so high. So if you restrict an airflow when it's not winter, you are causing damage to the engine. And of course, you know, once you cannot be able to regulate the heat of the vehicle, you are subjecting the vehicle to some extensive damage, especially when it comes to overheat. So when you have an overload of heat, then you have a problem. One of the things that the viewer should know is in this main section, when you look at the vehicle radiator, it has got also a section which cools hydraulic fluid for the gearbox. You know, the hydraulic fluid for the gearbox, sometimes it is made to saturate within the radiator area. The radiator has been constructed in such a way that inside it has got what we call a cooler, and as you cool the coolant in the radiator, at the same time you lower the temperature of the hydraulic fluid of the ATF, which is in the gearbox. So if you don't take care of this cooling effect on the vehicle, you are also going to affect the way the gearbox of your vehicle, especially the automatic transmission, operates. So the grille is very necessary in making sure that the air flows, adequate air flows into the engine section area, and make sure that it cools the vehicle adequately. So it's not apart from the, you know, the design. Of course, the design is a secondary reason, because of course a grille is put in place to enhance the outlook of the motor vehicle. So if the outlook is not enhanced, then you have the vehicle looking ugly. Secondly, you can still also be able to drive a vehicle if you don't have a grille on. But the other, of course, reason why you have the grille on is to prevent, there are some objects that would fly into the radiator unit and also the condenser unit for the AC. So for example, if you're driving and a stone flies, it will not be able to damage the AC condenser as well as the radiator, because once the stone flies, it will be stopped by this grille. Maybe for you to be able to maximize the grille and also be able to protect your radiator from cloggings which come from maybe insects and dust and stones and also small, you know, pieces of plants, especially if you are driving the car in, maybe you are so much going up country or you go through bush areas, you can decide to put on a net. There are some metallic nets, the ones that are common in houses, which prevent mosquitoes from entering. So that is one of the things that you can erect on the grille, and then protect the radiator and the condenser from receiving foreign deposits that will come and affect the fins of the radiator or the fins of the condenser. That one is agreed, because that net allows the flowing of air. It does not seal off the drag resistance, so it does not seal off the flowing of the air. So it's one of the things that you can erect, and I've seen in some organizations, especially organizations that have you know, big vehicles, and they are operating in rural, hard to reach areas where the dust is much, the insects are much, as well as, you know, they have to drive off-road and go into maybe bushes. I've seen them do that by erecting a net, and once they put a net on the grill, it will protect the radiator as well as the condenser for the air conditioning system. Now, when that air flows into the grill and goes to the radiator, of course, the radiator has got fins, and from those fins, it is able to dissipate the heat into that air, and then behind it is, of course, a fan that blows the air, the hot air, which has removed the temperature from the radiator, and then it blows it away. So, whichever the case may be, it's very important for you to take care of, you know, of the grill and make sure that it is not obstructed, neither to make sure that it's not destroyed, so that you protect the inside parts from the foreign deposits that fly like stones, as well as protect the beauty of the vehicle. Yeah, to some people, the beauty of the vehicle is cardinal. Sometimes I've seen people buy cars in very, you know, bad condition, but because the vehicle looks more posh and looks more beautiful, so they decide to buy it and then have to deal with other issues later. So the grill, a secondary reason is also to enhance the beauty of the car. And once the grill is not there, the car will simply look so ugly. So it is important to take care of, you know, of your grill. Of course, having discussed the grill, and so we having seen the purpose of the grill, then when you look at the car, you definitely, you know, appreciate the reason why the grill is in place. And once that is in place, you appreciate why the grill is in place, then you take care of your vehicle.